poor Dennis was in disgrace. About a week and a half ago, he made Billy do his banking duties by pretending to be ill. What he didn't know was that Billy had a slight fear of going up hills, and that caused him to have an accident when banking Molly's goods train. Of course, the fat controller found out his fibs and had him confined at the yards as punishment. Dennis now felt dreadfully guilty and wondered if he could be let out again. Just then, Thomas arrived with a train of stone trucks from the quarry. "Hello, Dennis," Thomas said. "You don't look very happy." "I'm in big trouble, Thomas," sighed Dennis, and he told Thomas everything. "Another one of your lies, huh?" Thomas huffed suspiciously. "That was certainly uncalled for. I once did the same thing 18 years ago." "Wait, you told a lie?" said Dennis, surprised.
"Oh yes," confided Thomas.
"But not an excuse to get out of work, but because I broke a promise."
"Well, how did this happen?" asked Dennis.
"Well, brace yourself," advised Thomas. "This all happened on this day 18 years ago before you arrived a year later." And this was the story Thomas told. The seasons were changing on the island of Sodor. The leaves had begun to change color. The air was growing crisp. Thomas the Tank Engine was feeling restless. "Summer is almost over, and I haven't had any fun," he complained one morning.
"You're a fussy little engine," replied Gordon. "We're not here to have fun. We're here to work."
That didn't make Thomas feel any better. "I'd rather be fussy and fun than bossy and boring," he replied. The next morning, the Fat Controller called the engines together at Nafford Station.
"We are opening a new branch line tomorrow," he announced. "I'll need one of you to check the signals on it to make sure that they're all working properly." "Who will volunteer?"
"I'll do it, sir," Thomas piped up. "Checking signals wasn't much fun, but it was better than being bossed around in the yard."
"Off you go then," said the Fat Controller. "And be sure to check every signal, Chamish. Safety is our first concern."
Something about shiny new tracks always put Thomas in a good mood. He whistled merrily as he rolled down the new branch line. "Checking signals is really useful," he thought. "After all, safety is our first concern." Each time he saw a signal, Thomas made sure that the arm was in the right position. He also checked to see that the signal lamp was working, so it could be seen at night. There were hidden junctions, cane rocks, dangerous curves, and steep hills. Thomas had almost reached the end of the new line when he saw a sign for a festival. There was nothing Thomas loved more than a festival. Oh, how he loved to go. "If I hurry to the festival now," he told himself, "I can check the rest of the signals later." And with that, Thomas turned off and headed into the countryside. The festival was splendid. There were games and rides and cotton candy, and there were lots of children. Trevor the traction engine was giving them hay rides.
"Look, everyone," he called. "Here's Thomas."
And he led the children over to greet the little blue tank engine. When Thomas got back to the sheds, the Fat Controller was waiting.
"You've been gone a long time, Chamish," he said. "You must have done a thorough job of checking the new signals on a new branch line."
"Yes, sir," peeped Thomas. And just like that, without thinking about it, Thomas told a lie. And not only that, he had broken his promise. He hadn't meant to. He suddenly realized that he'd forgotten to go back and finish the job. But how could he tell that to the Fat Controller?
"Good," beamed the Fat Controller. "Then everything is ready for tomorrow's grand opening."
Thomas gulped. What if there was trouble? What if the unchecked signals didn't work?
"I know," he thought. "I'll get up very early tomorrow and go out to check the rest of the signals before the grand opening."
That night, Percy was being loaded for his mail run when an urgent call came in. Rain had washed out a section of track on the mail route, which meant Percy would have to find a way around.
"You'll have to take the new branch line, Percy," said the postmaster. "It's quicker that way."
"It's risky," said Percy, "but the mail must be delivered right on time." The rain fell heavily, but Percy pressed on. Each time he saw a red signal lamp, he slowed down carefully until he passed the dangerous spot. Then, suddenly in the dark, Percy passed a signal. The lamp was not lit, so
so he didn't see it until it was too late. And there it was ahead, a very dangerous curve.
Oh no!
cried Percy. He shut his eyes and slammed on his brakes. But the rain made the tracks very slippery. Percy did his best to hold on through the turn. Or on the other hand, his last two mail vans flew off the tracks and smashed to bits on some rocks and bushes. Percy shivered with fear from his close call. The next morning, Thomas awoke and sneaked out of his shed. Then he saw Percy returning with the Fat Controller.
Percy has had a terrible fright last night, the Fat Controller said sternly. He almost derailed because of a signal lamp that didn't work. How could such a thing have happened, Thomas?
Oh, sir, I'm so sorry, sir, Thomas sputtered.
It all came rushing out about the festival, Trevor, the children, and how he'd forgotten to go back and finish the job.
I'm sorry I told a lie and broke the promise, sir, said Thomas sheepishly. I just wanted to be part of the fun.
There'll be no fun for you for quite some time,
scolded the Fat Controller.
Percy will run your branch on until you've gone and checked every signal on my railway twice.
And now, every time Thomas passes a signal, he checks it twice just to be safe. Gordon still likes to tease him.
Fussy little Thomas certainly is fussy about signals.
And why wouldn't I be? Tooted Thomas. Safety is our first concern.
So you broke your promise by forgetting to finish your job? Asked Dennis once Thomas finished his story.
Yes, murmured Thomas.
Because of Percy's accident, I started having fears of going past the dangerous curve about a week later until I fired off.
He looked closely at Dennis.
So now you see, Dennis, he concluded,
that telling lies will get you nowhere. They'll just lead to severe consequences. And unfortunately, you're on one right now. Dennis sighed and looked at his buffers in shame.
The Fat Controller did let it slide eventually, Thomas smiled sympathetically. And who knows, maybe he might do the same thing to you, if you tell the truth.
Do you think so?
Said Dennis, cheering up a bit.
I know so, grinned Thomas. Everyone's very forgiving when you tell them the truth, and that makes you a very honest engine.
Thank you for telling me your story, Thomas, smiled Dennis. I was wrong to make Billy do my job. I just didn't know that he has a fear of hills.
Well, you're in luck, said Thomas. I saw Billy at the other side of the yards, so this could be your chance to apologize and tell him the truth.
So Dennis set off to do just that. Dennis apologized to Billy and told him the truth, and sure enough, Billy forgave Dennis, and both are now firm friends.
Dennis wasn't sure why Billy was afraid of hills, but that's another story.